Lorenzo Lamas, he's at least a likable asshole in the beginning.
Sure. Yeah, so...
Because you get a chuckle or two out of it.
Yeah. So then, you know...
a real sweetheart of an asshole.
So then this girl shows up...
Aren't they all?
You know, to start the drug deal, and there's this extended scene of, I think you're wearing a wire. And he's like, well, I think you're wearing a wire. Well, we should just both strip and prove we're not wearing wires.
Mm-hmm.
And so they strip slowly, very slowly.
Back and forth. While they keep cutting to the guys in the car who are just like... Mm-hmm. Faces up inside the radio, just panting.
Well, that and they're like,
"What? How's he gonna hide the wire?"
And eventually, yeah, they get naked and have sex, and
right there on the floor.
Yeah, on this
the dirtiest floor ever.
Sure.
It's like, yeah, why not?
And then he wakes up to the two guys standing over him, kicking him, and basically trying to rip him off. Like they don't have any drugs.
Saying they don't have any drugs, but they want the money anyway because they got a gun on him.
Yeah,
and she's just kind of like. Suddenly, like, oh, it took you long enough to get here.
Yeah. This was my plan all along.
Yeah, which is a little odd, but.
Distract the guy, I guess.
Yeah. So, anyway, suddenly he magically has his pants on.
Yeah, sure.
And they're like, go get the money. He's like, it's in the other room over here. Why don't you come over, find it? So, of course, they go in there and he reaches in the corner. And this was the first holy shit moment of the movie that we had. Because for a while, we're just like, okay. Like. The only other thing we were like, what the fuck is going on here is, you know, one, it takes forever for them to strip.
Yes.
And two, when this chick takes her top off, there's just a huge scar going right down the middle of her chest. And we're just like, what is that? What the fuck is that?
It's a seam. It's where they sewed her together.
But yeah, sure. So we're like that. But then he gets the other guys in the room and they're like, hey, you know, where's the money? Reach in, pull out the money. And he reaches in and flips some kind of switch. That immediately makes like 100 spikes come out of the floor.
Yeah, and like it's just like spikes of some guy. I mean, they're I don't know. They almost look homemade. They're crazy.
They're like 4 inches tall either way, and they just go through these guys' feet, and they immediately are screaming bloody murder and drop their guns, and then he's just like slowly pulling a cigar out and lighting it up. He's like, so are you guys? So do you have any drugs or what's going on here?
Yeah, the way they originally established him, he's like a cross between John Rambo and Martin Briggs, you know? I mean, he's just like, he's fucking weird. Like, he's a loose cannon with a really weird, morbid sense of humor.
Yeah,
it doesn't carry for the rest of the movie, I'll just say that. Like,
but it's,
this opening scene is bizarre.
And it's kind of awesome. Because I was like, yes, this is the kind of thing we're in for. And then, of course, the girl sees this and freaks out and tries to run out the hallway. And she's like, I wouldn't do that. And then she gets caught in a net. And he said, he has booby-trapped this entire ancient warehouse for whatever reason.
Mm-hmm.
And then the cops bust in. They're like, what the fuck are you doing?
God damn it, snake eater.
To which he says, well, I could have done this. And he hits another switch or whatever and drops a 12-gauge shotgun out of the ceiling
that
and almost
at their feet.
Almost shoots them. I mean, it was really fucking close.
Yeah. And that's when Larry Zonka's just like, I have a Super Bowl trophy. You cannot do this to me.
I'm the all-time leading rusher of the Miami goddamn Dolphins.
Give me your badge. Ricky Williams sucks. You realize this.
I don't even know who Ricky Williams is. Well, he sucks.